Once in a while, you get a revolutionary change in the world, and this is one of those times. We are getting all of these artificial intelligence tools that are popping out everywhere, and our job is to either put our head in the sand and say, this is not going to happen, because that's what happened with the tractor, and that's exactly what happened with the internet. People said, this was a fad, it's not going to work, we have not been doing this, it's not going to, etc., etc. And my message to you today is, you need to put them in your workflow and embrace them in your life. They are not going to go anywhere. We just need to work with them. Maybe they're going to replace jobs, but every time jobs are replaced, there's new jobs that pop up as well. So in this video, we're going to compare ChatGPT and Canva Magic Write. Your Canva landing page or your Canva dashboard comes with a new feature that's called Docs. When you scroll down, it will also be on the topic that says you might want to try Doc. When you open and you click on Start Writing, then the document opens up. So Canva is taking up the big giants, the Google Docs, as well as Microsoft Word. So once you've opened up your Canva Doc, so you could start typing, like I'm typing right now to create a document. Or when you hover on the plus button, it will give you a hint to say that if you press the slash key, you get to view the magic of the slash key, where you could pick on Magic Write, start designing, picking the heading, subheading, the body, embedding videos, etc., websites, adding tables, bullets, emojis, pie charts, and so on. These are all the shortcuts that are available. Not only on a document, on all of the documents on Canva, you could use a slash key and then you find this. However, Magic Write is only available if you've opened up a doc and not any other format when you're designing. So for our video, we're going to be testing the Magic Write. When you select Magic Write, it gives you the option to ask the artificial intelligence to help you with whatever information that you want, or if you wanted to write for you a covering letter, or five tips to create a YouTube video, whatever writing, that's exactly what it's called, Magic Write. So it's going to help you write better. The bloggers should be jumping up and down for this feature because it is freaking amazing. It gives us an example. You know, it gives us a tip to say, write five tips on how to overcome writer's block. So you could click on write an example, and then it will give you an example of what you could be asking the AI to do for you. You could click on try another and try another until you find something that works with you, or you could create your own. And I'm going to ask it to create a cover letter for me, for a job that I'm applying for a learning and development practitioner, and I will give it information, because the more information that you give, the more that it's going to give out. Garbage in, garbage out. Once you've added the information that you want the AI to create for you, you press enter, and then it starts generating the outline for us. This is like cheating life, I'm telling you. I tell you, this is like cheating life. And then it starts writing the covering letter for me. And it starts with, dear hiring team, I am writing to apply for the position with 13 years of... And then it, yo, Gosem, throughout my career, I had an opportunity to design, develop, and deliver engaging. And this is like cheating life. Of course, you're going to tweak it and humanize it the way that you want, but it gives you the whole letter as you want. It is absolutely amazing, in my opinion. So if you wanted to create like a, I'm asking for YouTube, then I'm asking you to give me five tips for using the Magic Write tool. And then I press enter, and then it starts generating. And then it gives me the five tips that I could be scripting, or I could even tell it script for me, and then it'll write a script for me. In a summary, that is the difference between using the Canva Magic Write That's only available on Canva Docs for now. And we are super excited. Let me know in the comments below if you're going to start using this tool. And if you're excited as much as I am excited, let's jump right in and compare it with the ChatGPT. So with the ChatGPT, I'll link it on the description below. You can sign up using your Google account or your email, or you could log in. So I have created an account already. I'm going to log in using my Google account, and then I'm in on the ChatGPT. This is the free research preview. We don't know how long the preview is going to be. As much as it's available, it is researching, and when you are signing up, they will ask you questions and verify your cell phone number in order for you to access it and land on this page. And it is a tool that is designed to create virtual agents, chatbots, and other automated conversation. This tool also helps you write better. And we're going to test it as well using the way that we've tested on Canva. However, it is not limited to magic writing like on Canva. It is capable of much, much, much more because it codes as well. And I've seen amazing things that the ChatGPT does. So go ahead and go play around on the tool. You're just going to love it. What I'm going to be sharing with you today, because we're comparing to the Magic Write of Canva, is how are we going to be using the tools to write and get more out of the tool itself. So when you land here, it will show you the examples that you could write to get information out of the tool. And then it shows you the capabilities of the tool, as well as the limitations that are available on the tool. Once you're in, you're going to be on this functionality at the bottom, more like a writing space where you instruct the AI of what it is that you want it to help you with. So I want the tool to help me write a covering letter like we did with Canva, and then you type the instruction on there and you click next, and then it starts generating. Okay, and then it's done. I just love the way that it speaks like a human being. Oh my word, this is really like cheating life. And that's as easy as that. That's how you generate a covering letter. However, like I said, you need to give it as much information as possible that you would like to be on your letter. For example, if you're applying for a financial manager and there's certain skills that they want and you're looking at that on the spec, add it on there because it won't know what kind of skills you're applying for, and it's going to help you when you're applying for a job. I just absolutely love these AI tools. I'm not going to be one of those people that put their head on the sand and behave like the world is not changing as we know it, because these tools are really turning the world on its head. So I'm going to ask it to write me a script. Let's see what it says. Write me a script of benefits. And now it starts talking like a human being. Hello, welcome, and a quick overview. And then it starts giving me the benefits. So I'm going live and I'm going to be sharing the benefits of using Twitter for business owners. The tool also saves the chats on your left-hand side. So I searched earlier on the Canva Magic Resize. So when you click on that, it saves it on there. The covering letter that we did just now, as well as the Twitter, it will also save that on the left-hand side. Once you don't want the information anymore and you want to clear it, you can click on clear and then you can also log out. You can talk to the AI guys or the OpenAI team via their Discord, as well as look at their updates and FAQs. If you're one of those people that like dark modes, that's also available. Overall, Canva's Doc Magic Write tool is amazing, and it is on Canva. You're already in there, you're designing, and you could add videos, etc., with what you've seen already. So I don't know if it's a fair comparison. Actually, I really don't think it's a fair comparison. That's like comparing an apple and an orange, because the one will write for you and it'll add videos for you, and it is a feature that's already on Canva that we love. So while you're busy designing, the tool is available for you to help you write better while you're already in there. ChatGPT, an orange, is completely, even though it writes for you, it has more. You could create virtual agents, you could code, you could create chatbots, you could create automated conversation. So it's so, so, so much more. comparing the two would be completely unfair. I would use both tools depending on whatever need and a scenario that I'm busy with. I'm actually using both of them at the moment. If you like these comparison videos, I did a comparison of a Canva versus Adobe Express. So you could watch this next video that's going to show you what's the difference between Canva as well as Adobe Express. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on the next video.